In the early morning light, as the sun rises over Annandale, a boy about 17 years old starts hammering the tiles and marble stairs at the front of our house. Mama wakes and runs outside in her nightdress. "That's my marble!" Mama yells. The boy freezes. "Moju, no!" shouts another voice, a man's voice coming from across the street. That man, it turns out, is Morris. He's a tiler. He's meant to be retiling another house in Annandale. But his apprentice got confused and started destroying the front of our house. Mama's been relaying this to me in our kitchen, and then she says, "So I've decided to engage Morris and Moju's services to officially retile our house." "Mama, sounds like a very, very, very bad idea," I say, representing the voice of everyone. The next day, Morris and Moju come over and smash every remaining tile out the front of our house, load them into their truck and leave. They promise to finish the job by the end of the week, but they don't come back and they stop answering calls and emails. At the end of the week, the front of our house is an open cut mine gashed into the face of Annandale. And I'm angry. And I have a very strong compulsion to deal with it the only way I know how. Screaming. Because I'm a screamer. You're a dropper. I'm a screamer. My mama is a screamer. Her mama is a screamer. It's how we get shit done. "Mama, how's about we go around to Morris's place of business and do some screaming?" "No," Mama says. "I think we should try not screaming at this man." "Huh," I think. "Not screaming. Maybe I will quit screaming." Days and weeks pass and Morris sends the occasional text to say he'll be around soon, but he never comes and I don't scream at him. In fact, I don't scream at any man. I don't scream at the investment scammer who calls me every other day and refuses to take me off his call list. I don't scream at the 60-year-old man marching down the street who physically moves me out of the way and tells me to learn how to stand. And when I'm out driving with my friends and it takes me a little longer, okay, significantly longer than a normal person to park the car, and a man comes up to us, hits the side of the car with his fists and screams muffled threats through his window, I don't scream back. I don't even scream when we get out of the car and he starts filming me and my friends with his phone. In fact, an unexpected serenity descends. I am still. I am the Dalai Lama. "Can I talk to you?" I ask. "Fuck off," he says, still filming. "Listen," I say, "I've only been driving for 2 weeks. That's why I'm not very good at it." And the man looks at me and then he looks down at the baby he's realized is inside me and I could almost see his little heart shrivel up like a raisin through his shirt. "I'm so sorry," he says. I turn my heel and walk away. My friends can't believe it. "You didn't even scream at him." "I know," I say. "I have quit screaming." When we get back to the car several hours later, there's a note on the windshield. It's from the guy who shouted at me. He says he's sorry, that he believes he's a good person, and that he believes I'm going to be an amazing mum. I shudder. Attached to the note is a $50 Coles Myer voucher. In the morning, there's movement out the front of the house and I open the door. It's Morris. He's picking up some of his tools or whatever bullshit he's left there for 2 months. "Have you come to fix the tiles today?" I ask. "No, I can't," he says. "I can't because of the weather." I look out into the clear blue sky. A seagull wings lazily past the beating sun and winks to say that he, too, a simple bird, knows that this is statistically perfect weather for tiling. I look back at Morris and for a moment, silence. And then suddenly I feel the rumbling start in my diaphragm. They move up to my lungs, to my throat. The words and phrases are mustered at the gates of my tonsils. And as I stare Morris dead in the eyes, the words turn into magma and burst out of my mouth, and I absolutely Pompeii that man. I scream him a new asshole. I scream every scream I haven't screamed in the past 2 months. Mum comes outside. "That's enough, Zoe," she says, putting a hand on me. But I can't help it. I could never stop mid-wee, and I can't stop mid-scream. I scream him up, I scream him down, I scream him all around. Morris's flesh crackles and withers away as he staggers in the force of my pyroclastic scream. Then he blushes and he leaves. Mama looks at me and says, "Your boobs are falling out of your top." "I know," I say, "they came out in the screaming." By the end of the next day, the front of our house is perfect, with brand new tiles and swirling marble steps shining in the glinting sun. "Let's never stop screaming again," I say to Mama.